to explain ratio analysis. Let us solve one question. From the following particulars, you are required to compute current ratio, quick ratio, working capital turnover ratio, fixed assets turnover ratio, and current assets turnover ratio. And here in particulars, stock, debtors, bill receivable, advance paid, cash in hand, COGS is given. And here creditors, bills payable, bank overdraft, net sales, gross block, and accumulated depreciation. First of all, let us understand the formulas of ratio. The first formula, student, is current ratio. See, current ratio. Current ratio is equal to current assets divided by current liability. See, you have to remember that from current to current, current say current hota hai. So current assets divided by current liability, just for your remembering purpose. Then quick ratio. Next formula is quick ratio. Quick ratio is quick assets divided by current liability. Then third formula is working capital turnover ratio. See the name, it is given turnover. Turnover ka matlab hota hai sales. Turnover ka matlab hota hai sales. So sales आपको इधर ऊपर लिखना है जहां जहां फॉर्मूले में इन नेक्स्ट फॉर्मूला आल्सो फिक्स असेट्स टर्नओवर रेशियो जहां जहां पर टर्नओवर है आपको ऊपर सेल्स लिखना है एंड इन लास्ट फॉर्मूला आल्सो करंट असेट्स टर्नओवर रेशियो टर्नओवर जहां है वहां पर आपको सेल्स लिखना है. नाउ कम टू द दिस फॉर्मूला वर्किंग कैपिटल टर्नओवर रेशियो. तो टर्नओवर का आपने सेल्स लिखा है एंड रिमेनिंग पार्ट इज वर्किंग कैपिटल. सो यू हैव टू राइट वर्किंग कैपिटल. एंड स्टूडेंट व्हाट इज वर्किंग कैपिटल. Working capital is current assets minus current liability. This is working capital. Yes. Next, fixed assets turnover ratio. Already you have written sales and the remaining part is fixed assets. So, आपको क्या लिखना है? Fixed asset. Net fixed assets. Means you have to deduct the depreciation. Fixed assets में से आप depreciation minus करोगे तो आपको मिलेगा net fixed assets. And last one is current assets turnover ratio. So, आपने तो sales लिखा है and then you have to write the remaining part current assets. This is your student solution. Now, next one is working note. This is your working note. Working note. Come to the question, students. First item is given stock. Stock, student, is your current assets. And the amount is given 70,000. तो आपको stock में current assets में जाना है और आपको first item लिखना है stock. And stock is given how much? 70,000. Like this, you have to write. Next is given debtors. Debtors is also what? Debtors is your current assets. Debtors is your current assets. And amount is given 40,000 rupees. So, aapko jana hai debtors. In current assets, you have to write here debtors. And amount is given, student, 40,000. Now, next one is bills receivable. Bill receivable is also your current assets. Bill receivable bhi aapke current assets hai. Amount is given 20,000. And in advance paid also, advance paid is also your current assets. So bills receivable 20,000 and advance paid 10,000. So bill receivable 20,000 rupees and advance paid 10,000. Now next is cash in hand. See, cash in hand is also your current assets. Cash in hand bhi aapke kya hai? Current assets hai. So cash in hand, now you have to write cash in hand. Cash in hand
एंड द अमाउंट इज गिवन 30,000 कैश इन एंड 30,000. So here you have to write 30,000. So here we have completed our first working node, that is current assets. So 70, 40, 20, 10, and 30. If you add up this total, then you will get 1,70,000. तो आपके करंट असेट्स कितने मिल गए? 1,70,000. तो जहां जहां पर करंट असेट्स लिखा है आप यहां पर जाके लिख दीजिए 1,70,000 स्टूडेंट्स. यहां करंट असेट्स है एंड करंट असेट्स इज गिवन इन दिस फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो. सो हियर ऑल्सो यू हैव टू राइट 1,70,000. नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट, दैट इज क्विक असेट्स. व्हाट इज क्विक असेट्स स्टूडेंट्स? स्टूडेंट्स जितने भी करंट असेट्स होते हैं वो सब आपके क्विक असेट्स होते हैं, सिर्फ और सिर्फ दो चीजों को छोड़ के. एक होता है स्टॉक, एक होता है आपका स्टॉक, और दूसरा होता है आपका एनी प्रीपेड. जो भी प्रीपेड है ये आपके कभी भी क्विक असेट्स में नहीं आ सकते हैं. तो स्टॉक नहीं आएगा और प्रीपेड नहीं आएगा, इन दोनों को छोड़ के हम सब कुछ लेंगे. तो देखिए यहां पर स्टॉक है 70,000 का, तो स्टॉक को हमको नहीं लेना है क्योंकि ये हमारे क्विक असेट्स में कंसीडर नहीं होते. नेक्स्ट वन इज डेटर्स. डेटर्स इज योर क्विक असेट्स. सो डेटर्स क्विक असेट्स, डेटर्स 40,000 रुपीज. नेक्स्ट वन इज बिल रिसीवेबल. बिल रिसीवेबल इज ऑल्सो क्विक असेट्स. So bill receivable amount is same 20,000. And next one is advance paid. Advance paid is what? Prepaid only. So we are not going to consider this amount. Now next one is cash in hand. So cash in hand is 30,000 rupees. So here we will write 30,000. If we total 40 plus 20, 60, and 60 plus 30, 90,000 rupees. So 90,000 is your quick assets. ये दो नहीं आए. 90,000 is your quick assets. तो जहां जहां पे quick assets लिखा है वहां पर लिख दीजिए 90,000. Now come to the question again. See, here it is written cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold is given 4,22,000. And here sales is also given. Sales is given 5 lakh rupees. तो देखिए जब भी COGS जो है वो सेल्स का सब्सिट्यूट है तो हम COGS को इस पर्टिक्यूलर क्वेश्चन में कंसीडर नहीं करेंगे. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू कंसीडर दिस COGS इन दिस क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट वन इज क्रेडिटर्स. Creditors is given 10,000 rupees and creditors is your current liability. So creditors is your student's current liability. So here you have to write creditors. Creditors and amount is given 10,000 rupees. Now next. Now next one is bills payable. Bills payable is also your current liability and amount is given 40,000. तो आपको यहां जाना है current liability में and you have to write bills payable amount is given 40,000 rupees. Now next. Next is given bank overdraft. Students bank overdraft. Bank overdraft is also a loan. So this is your current liability. An amount is given 50,000 rupees. So bank overdraft 50,000 rupees. Bank overdraft 50,000. If you add this, then you will get 1 lakh rupees. 1 lakh rupees. Now next, see students. Now next is given net sales. See net sales is given 5 lakh rupees. तो जहां जहां पे sales है आपको जाके 5 lakh rupees लिखना है. See in working capital turnover ratio, in fixed assets turnover ratio, in current assets turnover ratio, हर जगह पे आपका sales है. तो here you have to write the 5 lakh rupees. 5 lakhs
5 lakhs, and here also 5 lakhs. 5 lakh rupees. Then fill the remaining part. What is remaining? Remaining is what? Fixed assets. Fixed assets is remaining. See, अगर आप क्वेश्चन में देखते हो स्टूडेंट्स, तो कहीं भी आपको फिक्स असेट्स दिया हुआ नहीं है. ना तो इस क्वेश्चन के अंदर लैंड एंड बिल्डिंग लिखा है, ना तो मशीनरी है, फर्नीचर है, कहीं भी नहीं है. बट इन दिस क्वेश्चन दे हैव गिवन ग्रॉस ब्लॉक. स्टूडेंट, द अनदर नेम ऑफ फिक्स असेट्स इज ग्रॉस ब्लॉक. तो ये आपका क्या है? फिक्स असेट्स है. सो यू हैव टू फिक्स असेट्स एंड डाउन इट इज गिवन एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन. So accumulated depreciation, so you have to deduct this depreciation from gross. So 1,40,000 में से you have to deduct 28,000, then you will get the remaining part 1,12,000. So see, 1,40,000 is your gross block. So here you have to write gross block minus depreciation, and gross block is given 1,40,000. And depreciation is given 28,000. अगर आप इसमें से माइनस करते हो, then you will get 1,12,000 is your net fixed assets. 1,12,000 is your net fixed assets. Go and fill up the information. Net fixed asset is given 1,12,000. तो आपको यहां पर आना है and you have to write 1,12,000. अब क्या क्या बचा है? Current liability हमने find out कर चुका है. Already we have find out the current liability and the amount of current liability is given student 1 lakh rupees. 1 lakh rupees आया है हमारा find out करने के बाद. So fill up the information. 1 lakh. 1, 2, 1 lakh rupees, and here also 1 lakh rupees. ठीक है. Now what is remaining? Remaining is what? Working capital. And what is working capital? Current assets minus current liability. Current asset is given student 1,70,000 and current liability is given 1 lakh rupees. If you minus 1 lakh from 1,70,000, then you will get 70,000 rupees. And 70,000 is your 70,000 is working capital. Yes. Now just you have to do the division part. Just you have to do the division. Students, 1,70,000 divided by 1 lakh rupees. If you divide, then you will get 1.7:1. This is your liquidity ratio and this is proportion method. 1.7:1. If you divide 90,000 divided by 1 lakh rupees, so you will get 0.9:1. Now see, if you divide 5 lakh divided by 70,000, then you will get approx 7.1 times. See, now you have to write the times because you are doing turnover ratio. जब भी हम turnover ratio लिखते हैं, तो उसका आंसर हम times में लिखते हैं. Then 5 lakh rupees divided by 1,12,000. Approx you will get 4.5 times. And 5 lakh divided by 1,70,000, agar aap karoge to you will get 2.9 times. This is your final answer. Thank you, students.